Okay, so we'll start with our second course, that is Java for Enterprise Edition. So it is called as J2EE. And so far we have seen about core Java. And in core Java, we have learned about basic concepts like classes, methods, and inheritance, then interfaces, abstraction, etc. So using the concept, we can develop a web application that is called Java for Enterprise Edition. So in this Java for Enterprise Edition, what we are going to learn is, so we will start with HTML, and HTML is used for like creating a websites. Then we'll use something called JavaScript, where JavaScript is used for validating the data in client side. And we will use something called CSS, that is cascaded style sheet. It helps us to design a web page, like more responsive web pages we can create with the help of CSS. And we can use something called servlet to perform something on a server machine. Like we will connect, we will create some data, and we will update that into a database, like that kind of stuff we will do with the help of servlet. And then we'll go for JSP, where JSP is a shortcut of servlet, where we can create a web application which is similar to a servlet. And then we will use something called JDBC, that is Java based like database application, or Java database connectivity, where we can able to connect our application with database. Then at the end of this course, we will learn about web service. Like we can create some application in Java, and we can make that application to be the part with other technologies like C Sharp, etc. That means we will create a service in Java that can be consumable with other technologies like C Sharp, etc. So, and we are going to use something called Apache Tomcat for creating an application server. And we will deploy everything, like we will deploy all the web application in this Apache Tomcat. And for the database connectivity, we'll use something called MySQL as the backend. So this course, it will take nearly like 9 hours to complete. So today we'll learn about HTML. Okay, so as the day progress, or as the course progress, we will learn more on JavaScript, CSS, servlet, and JSP, etc. So today's class, we are going to see only about HTML, and we will create some HTML program, and we will deploy that in Apache Tomcat, like that. So we'll do everything from the scratch. Okay, so is there any question about this syllabus? Do you have any question about this syllabus? Okay, so we'll proceed. So like I said, we are going to start with our HTML thing. So HTML thing is like, to create a web application, we have to use this HTML. So let me start with the HTML thing. Sorry, this is... So in today's class, we are going to deal about basic structure of HTML, and we will see some primary tags like bold, italics, underline, then br, hr, and p, and we'll focus more on font and image tag. Then we'll create some list tag. Then we'll use some tag tables, then form tags, etc. We'll create an application, and we will deploy that in Apache Tomcat application server. So we'll start with HTML. So HTML stands for like hypertext markup language. It is used for creating a websites, or creating a web pages maybe. And this was developed by Tim Berners-Lee, who has created this web page, and he also got awarded has awarded, like he got Turing, Alan Turing Award in 2016. It's a number one award which we can say in our computer field. It's called Alan Turing Award. So this person, Tim Berners-Lee, got this award in 2016 for his contribution towards this. So we'll start with HTML. So we are going to start with a basic one. So nowadays they are using something called HTML5. So that we will see when we go like detailed about this J2EE course. So let me start with the basic structure. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a folder. Say like week 5, like that. So I'm going to create a text document. And first we will see about the structure of HTML. So that is the basic structure of HTML. So HTML is nothing but it contains tags. Like these tags are represented by less than or greater than symbol. So in between we have to use the tag name. Like that, each tag will have like there are two types of tag. One is said to be container tag and standalone tag. Tags are there. So we'll see everything in a detailed manner. First we'll see the basic structure. So the structure is like, so we have to use this HTML as the topmost tag, that is the important tag. It will be the HTML tag. So it will be like less than HTML, then greater than. So everything which is less than, which is placed between the less than and greater than, it is considered to be a tag in HTML. Then we'll have like start tag and end tag as well. So when the tag is like, it has the start tag and end tag, then the tag is said to be a container tag. When you have only one tag, that is when you have a single tag, then it is said to be a standalone tag. We'll discuss that later. So we'll start with this HTML. So HTML, the main important tag is HTML. So inside HTML, you have something called head section. And you have something called the body section. And inside this head section, you will have something called the title section, where this represents the title of the web page. For example, the title of this document is new text document.txt hyphen notepad. So we'll specify the title of the web page like welcome to HTML, like that. So this represents the title of the web page, and it will be loaded at the title bar of the web page. Then then you can have like body tag in which the main content will be there. So main content will be there. So this is about the structure. So first HTML will have like head section, then inside head section you will have something called title section. Then we have to close the head section. Then we have like body section. Then you will have the main body content. Then you will have the close body, and we have to close the HTML. And one more thing about HTML is not a case sensitive markup language, where you can have like you can use both caps and small as well. And this is not HTML is not a programming language also, because this HTML language is said to be a markup language, where we can able to render the data to the user with the help of browser. So now what we can do is we can save this HTML, like for example, maybe we can create with the help of the file name index.html. So this is how we will create HTML. We'll use Notepad, and we can use the Eclipse also. But when we learn about Servlet and JSP, we'll use Eclipse IDE version. But as of now, we'll go with the Notepad like that. So what we can do is when you save that with index.html, you will see like a browser kind of symbol. So what you can do is you just right click and you just open with any browser. It will be get executed. And you can see like the title is welcome to HTML and you can see the main content here. So any doubt in the structure of HTML? Any doubt in the structure of HTML? So HTML structure, it is very simple. First we have to use something called head section. Then you will have some inside head section, you will have some title section. Then after that you will have a body and you will have like slash body, etc. So this is very basic HTML program. So nowadays you will have some doc type also. So first we will learn about the basic of HTML. Then when we progress with the course, we'll learn more about the doc type and metadata like that, which will be generated by the ID itself. So this is the structure of HTML. So first we have to use any text editor, like say Notepad or a WordPad maybe, and you type the tags. Then you have to save it with the .html format. Then you have to execute when you save itself, you can see the browser symbol. When you double click that, you can able to execute that. Okay. So now we will see about some basic HTML tags. So we also see that container tag is also there. So container tag is nothing but when a tag is like it has the start tag and end tag, then it is said to be a container tag. And we will also see the standalone tags. Okay. So now we'll see about how to make text to be bold, italics and underline. Then we'll see about br, hr and paragraph tag. There are so many tags are there, but these are the basic tags. And some of the tags in HTML where it's an olden style, I'm not going to use that, because for example, when you want to get some file with the help of HTML, we can directly use HTML5. So for that kind of tags, I'm not going to consider with the basic one. So when I take HTML5, I will use that. So what we'll see is we'll see some basic tags now, and then when we progress with the course, we'll see about HTML5 tags also. So next we'll see about bold, italics, underline tag. So bold tag, which will make the content to be bold. So the tag is, it's bold B like that. So it should have like start B tag and end B tag. So now I just convert this main content to be a bold tag. So what I will do is I will save this. I will open the browser or open the HTML with the browser, and you can see the main content, it will get bolded. Okay. So this is all about bold tag, which will make the content to be bold. So now we'll see about italics tag, that is I tag, which will make the content to be in italics format. Maybe like we'll see that. So the tag is like I tag is used. So now I will open the browser and I will just refresh. You see that the content is in the italics format, that is in slanted format, and this is all about the italics. And the next tag is underline tag, where which will make the content to underline itself. So the tag is underline. So again, I will go to the browser and I will refresh. You can see the content is getting underlined there. So these are the basic tags in HTML, where you can see bold, italics and underline. So next we'll see about breakline. For example, if I want to display the content, like first I want to display the main content with this, which is in bold. Then at the next line, I want to display the main content in italics. And after that, the next line, the content, the main content in underline like that. So for that, we'll use some standalone tag called br tag. So br tag is said to be a standalone tag because there is no end tag. We have a single tag. So this br tag allows to print the content in the next line like that. So I will just refresh, and you can see first the bold is displayed in italics, then underlined like that. So this is all about BR, and we will see one more tag called HR tag, which will create a horizontal rule in the HTML. For example, if I want to draw a line after this main content, I can do that. So I will just refresh. You can see the HR, that is horizontal rule, can be implemented here. That means it will draw a single line for you in a web page like that. So this is all about bold, italics, underline, BR, and HR. So next one is paragraph tag. So suppose if you want to display something in a paragraph, maybe you can use this paragraph tag. For example, paragraph P followed by some paragraph, like some content will be there like that. So we can close this paragraph. That means this paragraph gets in. So now we can, if we refresh, we'll get some paragraph like that. So we can align this paragraph. So by default, it is left aligned. So you can align this paragraph with help of so this P is the paragraph tag, and we can have something called align, which is said to be an attribute. And you can have you can make the alignment to be center. So this P is the paragraph tag, and align is the attribute tag, and center is the attribute value. So what it will do is it will align this paragraph with the alignment center. So when we refresh, you will see. So it is aligned with the thing center. So similarly, you can have like justify also. Justify. And then you will have something called align paragraph align right, which will align that in the right alignment like that. So this is all about very basic HTML tag. Okay, and I got a question in chat like, can we use like slash br instead of br slash like that? So you can use that like if you use like this way, it is also fine. So if you use like this way, it is also a fine one. So you'll get the same result, but you know, like there is a standard called W3C, where they will use something called br slash for or the tag name followed by slash for their standard. So when you see this W3C standard, we have to use the br tag like this one, this way. So if you neglect this slash also, it will work, but we have to put the slash at the last so that we have to follow some standard which is followed by W3C, that is Worldwide Web Consortium. So we'll get the same result, but we have to follow the standard like that. Any doubt? So the next one is, we have to use something called font and image tag. So font tag help us to like change the color or help us to change the text size, etc. So let me create some text. For example, so let me take some content from internet. So let me take some content from internet, yeah, like this. So I will put it in my page. So I'll put br tag for printing that in X lines. I am just putting that. So this is the content. I want to make this content to be in color. So what I can do is I can use something called font, and we can specify the color also. So for example, I'm going to print this in red color and with a size 20 maybe. So, and I will close this font like slash font like that. So if I refresh, so I will get the font color in red as well as the size of the font in 20 like that. So similarly, you can also change the face of the font. For example, when you create something in a HTML web page, you can see the font face is Times New Roman. And you can also change the font face, maybe like some different kind of thing. So I'm going to change this font face like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just open a WordPad. Word. And I'm going to select some font face, and I'm going to apply that here. So it gets opened. Okay. So I'm going to select the font face. By default, when you print something in web page, it will be like Times New Roman. But I'm going to change like some values like that. So I'm going to select something like okay, so I'm going to select this one. So I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to apply here. So font face equal to Comic Sans MS. Let me refresh. You can see the face is converted to a Comic Sans MS like that. So similarly, you can also change the font face like that. So the main purpose of the font tag is to make the color, to make the text to be color, and also to make the size, to change the size, and also to change the face of the text. So any doubt up to this? Any doubt? Any doubt up to this? Okay. So what is the, so I'm going to ask you one question. What is the default font face? When you create a HTML file with no font tag, what is the default font face will be applied? What will be the default font face? Yeah. So the default font face for whenever you create any HTML, the default font face, it will be like Times New Roman. And what is the default size of the text when you create anything in HTML? What is the default size of the font? So the default size of the font is 12. So we can also change the font size with the help of the size tag also. So next step is, so I'm going to insert some image into this page. So let me search for some image in online, maybe. So let me search for some images. Okay. So I'm going to save this image. So I'm going to save this image. Say image.image, like image.jpeg. So let me close other stuffs. So what I have did is I have downloaded some image called image.jpg. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert that image in my HTML program. So I will use br. Then there is a tag called img. So img src equal to file name image.jpg, like that. So this tag is also said to be a standalone tag. There is no end tag for this. So let me refresh the page. You can see the image is displayed here. So when you use image src followed by image name, what it will do is it will print the image with its own height and width. Suppose if I want to change the height and width of the image, I can also change with the help of the attribute height, say 100, then width, say 100, like that. So let me save this. Let me refresh. You can see the image size is changed from its original size to the width 100 and height 100, like that. So this is how we can insert an image into our HTML program. Okay. So to insert an image into our HTML program, what we can do is we can have img src, where src is src is the attribute representing the source, followed by the image name. Then we have like height and width. So height is represented in pixel and also width is represented in pixel. So if you don't put height and width, what will happen is it will print the image, or it will display the image in its original height and width, like that. So far we have seen about bold, italics, underline, then paragraph, then we have seen font, then we have seen something called image src, like that. So we'll go to the next topic called list. So list is nothing but arranging the element or arranging the data in order. There are two types of list. One is ordered list and another one is unordered list. So let me open a WordPad. Maybe I will explain you first what is ordered and unordered list. Then we'll go for this HTML code. For example, I am creating the content like HTML, Java, CSS, JavaScript, like that. So I want to make this in an ordered list. So what I can do is I can select this 1, 2, 3, like that. So this is said to be an ordered list, where everything is represented by like some number or maybe some alphabets, like that. And you'll have another kind of thing like unordered list, where everything is represented without any ordered representation of numbers. Instead, you will see some shapes like circle, square, like that. So to create an ordered list, so what we can do is, so first we have to use something called OL. So OL is for ordered list, slash OL is to close the OL. And OL is for ordered list, and we'll have some items, that is list items, maybe like HTML is first list item, so we can close that. And the second list item is CSS, and the third one is JS, like that. So now we can save this. And when you refresh, you see that the list is represented in order, because we have not mentioned this 1, 2, 3, but we have mentioned something called ordered list. So it will represent our data in an ordered format like 1, 2, 3. So by default, it will display that in 1, 2, 3. Suppose if I want to make that to a Roman letter, maybe we can have like type. So type is equal to, if you use small I, it will be using a small Roman letter like this. And if you use capital I, it will be representing that in a capital Roman letter. Or if you use ABA, or if you use AI, it will be displaying that in like alphabetical order like that. So this is all about ordered list. And by default, when you are not giving any type, it will display that in 1, 2, 3 like that format. So similar to ordered list, we'll have some other similar to ordered list, we have another thing called unordered list. So instead of OL, you have to use something called UL. So UL is for unordered list. And every items in this list can be represented by LI. And if I refresh, you can see the unordered list. By default, it will be in circle, that is dark circle. Similarly, you can change the type also. So you can change the type as, for example, you can use square. The list, it will be displayed in square format, yeah, like this. Similarly, if you use circle, similarly, you can use circle like that. So this is the representation of ordered and unordered list. Okay. So any doubt in this ordered and unordered list? So what is the default ordered list type and what is the default unordered list type? So if you are not giving any type, what will be the default ordered list and what will be the default unordered list? So the default ordered list, it will be numbers starting from 1, 2, 1, 2, 3 like that. And for unordered list, it will be like yeah, dot bullets like that. So this is the representation. So next we will go about table tags. So table tag is nothing but representing the data in the form of representing the data in the form of rows and columns like that. So let me create a new one maybe. So let me create a new text document, sorry, new HTML document. And you can see this title, the head section is an optional one. Here in this program, I'm not going to use this HTML head section. It's an optional one. So to create something in table, we should identify how many rows and how many columns are there, like that. So let me open a WordPad. Maybe first I will explain you the thing first. So insert, then we can select table like that. So here you can see the table has 4 rows and 3 columns. For example, serial number, name, age, like that. And this, the first row of the table is said to be table header because it will give the information about the column like that. And the second thing is said to be an actual data. So for example, 1, 2, 3 like that, X, Y, Z. So 21, 22, 23 like that. So what we'll do is we'll create this HTML table. So first, what you have to do is there is a tag called table tag. And we have to specify 3 attributes, namely width, maybe 100, height, 100, and border, say 2. Then we have to close this table. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create everything. So in table, we can create everything with the help of rows and columns. So first, I'm going to create the first row. So to create the first row, so what we have to do is we have to use something called tr for creating the row. We have to use slash tr for ending the row. So tr, the first, as I mentioned earlier, the first row of every table is said to be a header. So for example, serial number like that. Then you can have a name like that. Then you have age like that. So we have completed the first row. Then we'll have like the second row. And this row is actually a data. So we can use TD. The first serial number is 1. And actually the second name is like X. So the first name is X. And the age is like 22 like that. So first let me save this. So you can see the first, so since we mentioned the first row as the table header, you can see that in bold. Since the border is 3, it is you see the space between the border is also 3, and we mentioned the height and width also, so you can see that. So I'm going to add the second content or the second row. So 2y and 23 like that. 3z 24 like that. So let me refresh. You see that the content, it will be like in that format. Suppose I want to make this with a different color. So what I can do is, so I can change the color of the first row. So TR BG color equal to something like green. So what happened is the first row, it will be in green color now. You can see that. So similarly, if I want to change the other colors, I can also put the BG color for this one. Or if I want to change the background color of the table also, that is possible. So BG color equal to some maybe like pink like that. Okay. So you can see that the whole table is applied with the background color pink, and you can see that. So why we are learning this table is, in future we will learn about getting the content from the database. So we are going to display that with the help of this table like that. So we'll create a dynamic table like that. So for example, when you see the results of the student, all the like they can see serial number, the name of the subject and the mark obtained, then the status like whether he passed or failed. So everything they use something with the help of table. So with like we can extract the data from the backend like say MySQL, and we can display that with help of this table thing. So this is all about table in HTML. Okay. So any doubt in this table? Any doubt? Okay. So now we will see an important section. Now we will see an important section called forms. You see there are the form is nothing but it's a way in which it can able to get the content from the user. For example, there are many different forms you may see, like login form, sign up form, or application form like that. So everything they use something called a form tag. For example, here when you just open any account, say maybe rediffmail.com, You can see the sign up page or the login page like that. So everything, they use something called forms. So you can see the username and the password, this button, everything. It is like a form kind of thing. So we'll see that form actually now. So what you can do is first, let me open a new file. So first I will type HTML, then slash HTML like that. So then we'll have some body, then we'll have some slash body like that. So to create some form, maybe like we can use some form tag. And you see, like when you, for example, in sign-in form, when you type username and the password, so when you press submit, what actually it will happen is it will submit your username and password to the corresponding server. The server will validate your username and password. If the username and password is matched with the server, what it will do is it will enter into your home page and it will display your home page like that. So for that, we have to specify something called action. So when you submit this form, what will happen like that? So for example, maybe like validate.jsp. So it will not work now because we have to create a JSP for our understanding. I'm just putting that like action, like kind of thing. So when this form is submitted, it will go to this validate.jsp, and we can have a method also. There are two types of method. One is get or post. So I will explain you what is get and post when we execute this program. Okay. So this is how we can create a form, like form action equal to validate.jsp. What happens when this form is submitted? It will go to this validate.jsp. This validate.jsp will get the content of the form and it will process with the help of the server and database connectivity like that. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create maybe like username like that. So username, normally when I open this rediffmail.com, you see that you can see like a sign in form. You can see that username and followed by the text area or the text field where you can type actually the username, then password like that. So first let me create that one. So to create that, you can use something called input type equal to text. Then you can specify the name. Actually, maybe like, so since I am typing the username there, so I'm just putting that name as username, because this name is, it will come handy when you use like something called servlet JSP, because we will pass this username to the JSP or servlet with the help of this name called username like that. Then also you can specify the size, like size is equal to 20. Then this is also a standalone tag, so we can close that. So then we can put something called br tag at the end. So let me save this. So let me run this. So you can see the username. So what happened is I can type something and I can do like that. So to get some information in the text thing, so you can use something called input type equal to text like that. Okay, so I got a question like, what this validate.jsp, this is like, here it is dummy now. We have not created validate.jsp. So what it will do really is, when you submit this form, it will go to this validate.jsp. But now it is dummy because we have not created this validate.jsp. But when we learn about servlet and JSP, we will create this validate.jsp where it will pass the value like username to validate.jsp like that. And while validation, it will perform some operations like checking the username and password with servers like that. Kind of stuff it will do, but now it is dummy. So I will just tell you, now it is dummy. So now next one is, Like as you know that the next area in Rediffmail they are asking is password. So let me type the label as password. So input type equal to. So instead of text, you have to type password, because when you type something in password, it won't be visible to us, or it won't be, the text won't be visible to other to us. So you have to type input type equal to password and name equal to password like that. Again, size is equal to 20 like that. So let me close this. Then again, br tag to print that in next line. Let me refresh the page. So you can see when I type something in password, you can see that in dot, not as the text like that. So I will tell you what is get and post when you execute this. So for example, after typing the username and password, so I could create some button, input type equal to, so there are normally two types of button, one is submit and reset. So I can give input type equal to submit, value equal to login like that. So again, this is the standalone tag, then input type equal to reset, value equal to clear. So let me put that in, yeah. So now if I save this, you can see login and clear button is there. Now I will explain what is the purpose of a method get and post. Assume we are sending the data username and password to validate.jsp with method get. What happens is, for example, I'm typing some password like Arul Suju is my username, and Arul Suju at 123 is my password. Assume that I'm typing that. So when I log in, when I click on login, you see that if I use method equal to get, you can see the username is appended at the URL, like username equal to Arul Suju and password equal to Arul Suju at 123. Like at is represented by percentage 40 like that. So when you use method equal to get, the values of the forms will be appended in the URL. And when you use method equal to post, the value won't be appended. You see, like if I refresh, if I type something, if I click on submit, you can see the values are not appended in the URL. Since we have created something called the dummy validate.jsp, you can see the file is the file was not found like that. Okay, so this is all about method get and post. When you use method equal to get, what will happen is the form data will be appended in the URL, and when you use method equal to post, the form data will not be appended in the URL like that. So we will use something called like we'll use post, but some in some cases we will use something called get. And for making the content to be secure, we'll use post. But in some scenario, like in Ajax call or in some call, we have to know the parameter like that. So we will use something called get. But normally many of them, like 99.9% of the people, they will use something called post. So it is best to that we should use post. So now we have created like username and password. So let me like create one more thing. Like I will show you like full demonstration about the form. Let me convert this form into a registration form, so that I will just put, I will demonstrate all the tags in forms. So let me convert this login page into the registration form like that. So instead of password, I will just put password. And let me create another thing called confirm password. Confirm password. So I will make this password as password one and this password as two, like that. Then, so let me refresh. Yeah, I can see the registration page where username and password and confirm password. So normally what is the next one I'm going to create is, I'm going to create something called gender. So select your gender like that. So normally the gender, it will be like of two types, like male and female. So we can, like in gender, there will be like only one option must be selected, because the person cannot be like both male and female. So for that, you have to use something called input type equal to radio. So this will display that in radio, and name equal to maybe gender you can use. Then again, input type equal to again radio, name equal to gender. So I can put a value as male and female like that. So we have to specify the name as common for both male and female, because they are comes under the same category called gender. So let me refresh. You can see I can able to select only one option at the time. Suppose if you are not putting this name equal to gender, what will happen? Now let me check with that. Suppose if you just put the input type equal to radio, what it will happen is you can select both male as well as female, but we should select only one option. So since we have to put like name equal to gender, and name equal to gender like that. Okay. So next one is, I'm going to ask like user like area of interest, like games, like singing, like then outing like that. So I'm going to ask, like you can have multiple area of interest. So for that, we have to use something called checkbox. Input type equal to checkbox. Name equal to AOI. AOI is for area of interest, like that. So let me save this VR tag for breakline again. So here you can see in checkbox, I can select more than one option, but in radio, I can select only one option at a time. So let me use one more thing like address. Type your address. So what you can do is so you can also get the content of address with the help of input type equal text, but it's not flexible to do that. Sorry. So what you can do is you can use something called text area, and you can specify the rows, and you can also specify the columns. And this is like a container tag in which it will have like both start tag and end tag. So let me refresh. So you can see this is the address area where you can have rows as well as columns. So the difference between the text area and the thing is, like you can enter multiple line here, but here you can enter a single line like that. So this is all about text area. So you can also specify the name here. name equal to address. Okay, so what we are just dealing is, we are dealing with a very basic HTML thing. There are so many advanced versions of like tags is also there, so that comes under HTML5, where you can see like multi-line in text like that. So that is also possible. So that we can go when you go for like HTML5. So the next one is, I'm going to ask I'm going to demonstrate how the select tag will be. So how the select tag will be like, the next question in the chat is like, in the text area, if possible to enter numerical words, everything is possible. Like you can enter numerics and you can enter characters, or you can enter anything like in text area. So next one is, so I'm going to ask the user to select the country. Select your country like that. So for that select, we have to use something called select. Select name equal to country. Then you have to close the select. Here we have to give the options, like option, value equal to India. Then we have to display India here, then slash option, then option value equal to Sri Lanka. Then slash option. So let me refresh. So I'm going to display that in next line, maybe. So select your country like that. So I can have like India and Sri Lanka. If India is selected, the value here, it is the India will be passed. So similarly, if I use Sri Lanka, the Sri Lanka value will be passed like that. Okay, so this is a simple registration form. You can have the text, then you can have the password, then you can have radio button, check button, then you can have the text area. Then you can have like select your country like that. Let me show you. So this kind of registration form can be done with the help of this HTML thing. Suppose I want to use HTML5 like that. For example, I want to make the user to type the date of birth. So what I can do is I can just select your date of birth. So what I can do is I can just put input type equal to date like that, name equal to date. So this comes under the modern HTML5 tag. So you can see, instead of typing that, I can just select the thing and I can apply that. For example, like that. So this is like select your date of birth like that. So similarly, if I want to make the user to upload some resume on it, so what I can do is upload your resume like that. So there is an option called input type equal to file, name equal to file. Name equal to resume, I can say. So let me refresh. You can see there is a choose file where you can choose some file and you can upload that. So So this is a simple registration form. With the help of this form tags we can do, and also with the help of small HTML file tags we can do that. So you can also have like a frame tag. You can also have like frame in HTML, but this kind of frame is not used nowadays, because instead of frames they are using something called div span like that. So we will apply that, we will use that when we go for this HTML5 CSS and JavaScript. But this kind of olden tags are still now they are just using this kind of stuffs like that. And it is mandatory to know that this kind of stuffs they are using. But this frames and all, they are not using this this kind of frames. They are not using nowadays. It is deprecated or it is removed from this HTML, and we are using that. We are using a modernized format like that. So let me show you one program maybe. So this is like a registration page where I have created for my company. Where after this registration, what happens is when I submit that to, like, there is a registered user. So this is the registered user. It will get all the content of it will get all the content from that HTML form, and it will save that into the database like that. So this we will do that when we go for the JSP servlet like that. But so far, like, we have completed the basics of HTMLs, and we will use this HTML for our purpose. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to deploy this web page into the application server. So what normally the programmers they will do is they will create this file as the web page, and they will deploy that into the server. So normally we will use in Java technology, they are using something called Apache Tomcat, and it is freely available in a website called tomcat.apache.org, where you can download the latest version of Tomcat. Like, if you want to use it in Windows, you can use the 32/64-bit installer like that. So when you download that, you can see something called like this kind of symbol. So we will explain more on this, why there is a cat symbol in this like that. We will see that. So first I'm going to install this Apache Tomcat. So before that, we have to install Java into our machine. So first we have to install the Java kind of stuffs. Then we have to install this. So first, let me select next. Let me select then agree. Then select next. So you can see the port that HTTP uses is 80, and this Tomcat will be using 8080 like that. Then you like I said, you need to install Java before installing this Tomcat, because the Tomcat will be running with the help of Java virtual machine. When you install Java, it will automatically checks for the Java version, and it will show you. The next, then I'm going to install this Apache Tomcat in D drive, because normally in C drive you won't have a permission to edit the file. Then I will install. So once it gets installed, I will start the Tomcat. So you see, like, the Apache Tomcat will be started. Now what happens is my system is now becomes a server, because I have installed the application server into my machine. So to check whether the Apache Tomcat is installed in our machine, I can type localhost:8080 like that. When I press enter, you can see the welcome page of the Apache. In real time, you can't see this localhost colon 8080 where you can see something called your home page will be there. And in that home page, you can deploy your application like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this form.html into my Apache. So for that, so I will go to D drive. So I will go to program files, then Apache Software Foundation. Then I can see something called Tomcat 7.0. Then I can see something called web apps. What I can do is I can create a folder for my project. Maybe like I will use HTML. Then I can paste the form. Maybe I will rename with index, because normally the first page of the web page, it must be index. So I can go to the web page and I can type the folder name. The folder name is HTML followed by index.html. When I press enter, I can see the registration page. So what in real time, what they will do? Any doubt? Which I am getting in the chat is how we provide line space in two or like how we provide line space between two or more lines in registration form. So so likewise, so we can use a br tag, for example. Maybe I will just open. So if I want to have a multiple line, I can use br. Like I will have three space now instead of a single one. So this will allow us to have more than one line like that. Okay. So any doubt? Any doubt in this? So far we have completed the basics of HTML. Then we have seen basics of forms and how to deploy our application into the Apache Software Foundation. We'll have like more classes on Apache Tomcat. So why the name is Apache Tomcat like that, and we'll deploy that actually. So when you go for a Java kind of thing, we have to learn, we have to know about this Apache thing. Okay.